Dear W124 friends, fans and owners, this is Ivica speaking. And like always, at the beginning, I would like to ask you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet. Our current topic is going to be useful advice. These advice are for all those who have issues with their benzes. If you have any issue, like your car won't start, or it stalls after starting, or you have unsteady idling, or low engine power, then start with the mileage you made. So, each 50,000 kilometers, replace the air filter, the fuel filter, the oxygen sensor, check the spark plugs, check if they all have the same gap, 0.8 millimeters, and pour into the fuel tank injector cleaner. This is especially important for 6 and 8 cylinder engines. A faulty O2 sensor. How to know if you have a good or bad O2 sensor. The car jerks when starting. Extremely high fuel consumption, low engine power during accelerating, and a rise in emissions of toxic gases. Those are the symptoms of a faulty O2 sensor. Each 150,000 kilometers, you want to check the condition of the spark plug cables, the fuel accumulator, the fuel pressure regulator, the coolant temperature sensor, 2 rubber seals in the fuel distributor, the micro switch, the idle control valve, and the throttle position sensor. Replace the potentiometer and the injectors and their rubber seals. If you know for sure that your fuel pump, your fuel pressure regulator, fuel distributor and the airflow sensor are in a good shape, then you can start with the electronics. And here I would like to mention something. Don't touch the mixture screw. It is extremely important. For example, you have a duty cycle capable multimeter with which you can check your mixture air to fuel ratio, and you want to do that, but you can't do that without a good functioning O2 sensor. And what if your problem is the O2 sensor? For example, you want to adjust the mixture and you get the number 50, for example, 50%. As soon as the oxygen sensor warms up and the car gets to the operating temperature, the numbers in percents start fluctuating. And if your oxygen sensor is bad, then you will get a steady reading. As you get a steady reading and your car is at the operating temperature, then you should either check if your oxygen sensor is plugged in or if it is good functioning. So concerning the mixture, that's the last thing in the row you're going to do. The last thing. As soon as you have repaired everything on your car, and the last thing you want to adjust, it would be the mixture. My car won't start cold. If you experience cold starts, then you should check the coolant temperature sensor and the cold start valve. Everything you should know about the coolant temperature sensor, I will put the card here above. Concerning the fact that the coolant temperature sensor is bimetallic, it works the way that the two metals touch each other and separate from each other. It's a part that never goes bad. So for example, my coolant temperature sensor is operating for 31 years and it is still good functioning. My car won't start warm. If you experience warm starting issues, then you should know that your fuel accumulator is bad. Check your fuel accumulator. If you didn't watch my other videos, I can post a card here above about the fuel accumulator, how you can check it. Steady idle. Concerning steady idling, there are six components that should be checked. Those are the injectors, the idle control valve, the microswitch, the potentiometer, the O2 sensor, and the throttle positioning sensor. Now, let's see how everything works. As soon as the accelerator lever touches the microswitch of the decel cutoff switch, the computer, the ECU, knows that the engine is on idle. At the same moment, it sends the information to the potentiometer and to the throttle positioning sensor. The potentiometer we call, as if I literally translated it in my language, it would be the potentiometer which regulates duty cycle while idling. So the potentiometer fine-tunes the position of the plate on the airflow sensor. And the throttle positioning sensor. The throttle positioning sensor determines the height of the throttle, how it should be. Now, the O2 sensor sends information about the concentration of oxygen in the exhaust fumes, and now the only thing left for the ECU to do is to determine the fuel flow. And then the ECU sends the information to the EHA, which closes the passage in the fuel distributor, more or less to the limit with lean mixture. Again, checking steady idling. In order to check all of this, you should know that the idle control valve never goes bad. After so many kilometers or miles, however you want it, it can clog. And then you just have to remove it and to spray it with car cleaner, or you have to soak it in diesel fuel and leave it for a couple of hours. The throttle position sensor never goes bad too. As for mine, my TPS, throttle positioning sensor, is working for 31 years and it still works very good. So, and if you replaced the O2 sensor, the only thing left for you are the injectors. If you doubt the injectors, then you go and check for the emission of your exhaust gases. Because if you get high readings, then it can be either the injectors or the O2 sensor. As for the cutoff decibel switch, you only have to see the pivot points of your accelerator lever and lubricate them with the WD-40 so that the lever slides smoothly. That's important, that's because it's the first step for steady idling to be achieved. The lever must touch the little wheel on the micro switch. Okay, those were some useful advice. If you have any other questions, let me know in the comments below. If you liked this video, then please like it, share it, subscribe to the channel, and comment the video. And till the next video, happy Mercedes-y.